Hi guys, welcome to Money Machine. My name is Oriola John, as you all know. If you are visiting this channel for the first time, please click on the subscribe button, like this video, and then share with your family and friends, okay? Basically today, someone asked me in the comment section of my last video to talk about B second attempt scenario. So I'm going to be showing how it is done. So currently now, as you can see, let me remove my face, and I'm loading the page, and I want to search particularly for that car, for that person. Let me give myself a camera view. I think I see somebody, but I'm not sure. We're going to move within the frame, so it's loading. So I'm going to pause this video now till it's fully loaded, then we'll come back to look for that person that we are looking for. Okay, so let's. All right, it's fully loaded now. You can see it's loaded. So in my search, I found out something with camera view. When I looked at this position, I can see that there are two persons actually here. Ooh. A lady with a white top and another guy with a black trouser. So I think I should annotate this person first of all, then we look for any other person that we can find, see, and reduce the screen. So okay, I'm going to look for this person. I know he's here. I know he's right here, so can we go down? Good. So, do you remember how to clone? So we have the shift alternative and press the mouse left button and you drag, okay? So, yeah. This is where that guy is. That is making my friend troubled. He wants to get the stacks done, okay? So, finally I've gotten the guy. Okay, let's see him in the camera view. Oh, there he is. Okay, let's check out, this is the backside. Let's check the front side. Let's make sure everything is balanced. I think the leg is bigger than this. Okay. So, yeah. So we're going to shift backward. You know, shift and take the frame backward by 5 frames. And you see that this is actually a human being. He moved. And I'm giving it a size that I can contain him in every frame. And then we are looking at the overhead. We still, I think from here, I've not done anything bad here. So let's give him another back time again. So we have him here, but he's covered. So let's see him in the camera. This is him here. See? This is him here. And it's covered here. Let's go back again. This is him again. Let's make sure. And here. Alright. A V shape. Alright. And I think there's something here. Am I correct? Yeah. Very correct. So. Yeah, because I thought that much too. No, this is it. No, this is it. Okay, so his hands we at the back. Now we have him again. Okay, check the back view. Complete. Then we move again. Push him to this angle. check his view, correct? Again, yeah, he's okay, correct? No, it's not that correct. Check this view, let's push him to this side, correct? Again. Alright, so sorry for that. We're back here again, and we have to push in. We have it here again. Okay, and backward. Yeah, and then V. Okay. So we have another, and then we have another. So check. You have to check all the frame, check the back view. I think we need to give this guy height here. I don't know why, but yeah. Another. I think we need to give him some size in here. I think he's close to the ego vehicle here. And so let's see the picture we have, the camera view. Okay, roll down please for me. Wow. I'm gonna be good. We don't have a good camera view. So we have a good camera view, and then we have to shift it a bit again. We couldn't see it. Okay, we can switch camera to one. It's not clear, but we know we are annotating the right object. Alright, so we draw back. And then we shift again. I think this is the ground. Alright. I think it has a where they run in here because it's so fast. Let's see the few. Okay, and the last but not the least frame. Yeah, so technically, this was how I saw that guy. I was scanning through. I just pressed the F key or scanning through, and then I saw that there was a pedestrian here, so came closer and I saw him. Okay, so sometimes it just is to move around, check things around. Okay, I don't know if there's more than one pedestrian. Let me see. It could be more than one pedestrian in this All right, let's submit. Let's see what it says. Oh no. You can't submit. Okay, thank you. Yeah, you can't submit without. Incomplete attribute, overlapping keyboard. No, it wasn't having any light. Occlusion. I'm clicking 20% for everything. Overlapping. I'm canceling all this. I just want to show you, so I'm submitting it now. So you can check for the overlapping and then engage it, edit it to fit, but for me I just want to submit and just show you how to locate the pedestrian. So let's see, 67, maybe there was one other. Okay, probably because I did not, I just quickly wrote that down. So there are some few errors with this guy. So look at my answer key. Right, so those were the errors, okay? So look at this guy, see again. You see where they are at frame 80? Very close to the Eagle vehicle. So it's very easy to locate and then edit the other. So thank you so much for staying through. Thank you so much for staying through. So I believe you've gotten your answer at its frame 80 is where I stopped, so you can easily see that pedestrian that was walking along the road, the Eagles Road. So thank you for joining us. Thank you for subscribing. See you next time.